half orphan Mangoki. The ring-tailed lemur child no longer has a mother, but is fortunately taken care of by his father.
He'll hide from the others when there's something good to eat, otherwise he wouldn't have survived.
Weeks ago, Zebra Mare Vicky gave birth to a foal, jealously observed by leading mare Yassi in the adjacent box. Keepers Tony and Marcus can both confirm that Yassi demands the foal for herself. She attacks Vicky and won't tolerate any mother and child togetherness.
Yassi is constantly trying to drive the youngster away from his mother. She'll probably start trying to kick back and bite soon. The youngster is in stress because he can't get to his mother. This means that he can't drink any milk, he can't fortify himself. Really, in the long term, this is anything but healthy. He's just not going to grow.
As soon as the little one lays down, exhausted, and the mother comes closer, Yassi leaps between them and forces them apart.
Basically, we've got one foal and two mothers. One is the real mother, the other wants a forced adoption. Something has to be done, certainly. We have to think about how to deal with it.
Alpaca mares have year-long pregnancies. In this herd, the fourth alpaca baby within a month has just been born. Volker wants to see if mother and child are in good health.
This is left over from the amniotic sac. The tail still wrapped up. It was only born a few minutes ago.
Alpacas are camels from South America.
Hey, all right? Go and stand in the sunlight. It's much nicer. Yes, try and stand up. Straighten your legs. Yes, that's great.
You're fine.
You're doing fine.
Und ist wieder ein Junge, natürlich.
It is, of course, another boy.
Ist wieder ein Junge. Langsam.
A coincidence, but the number of male offspring really is curious.
1 year we only had girls, and this year it's nothing but boys.
The little one hasn't got such a dense woolen dress.
Come into the sun, it's really warm, you'll dry out nicely there. Come on, sweetie. Here's a good spot. Look, over here. Lovely. There, nice and warm.
So, guck mal. Prima.
A little bit wobbly, but it's standing. Alpaca herds are predominantly known in Bolivia, Peru, and Chile.
They have to learn to run fast with their mothers, otherwise they're easy prey for pumas. But first of all, they seek out the milk bar. First they want a drink, and then they'll run all over the enclosure.
The lavish wool impedes the search for the teats.
Mona, you have to move up a bit, then he'll find them.
Mm. Nangoki is a half-orphan. His mother died after his birth. His father took over the mother's role, something that rarely ever happens. Normally, only the females take care of the rearing. Keeper Heidi supports the caring father. Mangoki urgently needs to gain weight.
We feed him milk several times a day. He also gets a little fruit. The mother never had much milk, but his survival instinct was terrific. He ate a lot from the start. He's the first and the last at the feeding dish. He just sits there all day and eats and eats. He gets plenty of liquids from us, but he hardly gains weight.
The first thing Heidi does every morning is to take care of problem child Mangoki. The other lemurs are fed immediately afterwards. As is often the case, the three-month-old lemur clings to his father.
There's the dad, Gerard. He sleeps with his father too. He hangs himself under his belly like he did with his mum and sleeps there. He suckles on Gerard's breasts, but of course nothing comes out, he's a man. Maybe it calms him down.
Father and son make a good team. In the lemur world, women are in charge in all walks of life. They are higher ranking than the males. Meanwhile, Mangoki has got so used to Heidi that it's no problem for her to feed him, if she uses auxiliary means.
In the beginning, we held him in our hand, but he didn't really like that. So we had the idea to get him a cuddly toy. It's more or less the same shape and size as a real lemur. Anyway, he sat still then. We'll weigh him with his cuddly toy too, to make sure he's a little calmer.
Mangoki has only got to leave his beloved dad for a few minutes.
Can you give him to me? Yes, that's good. You see? All's well. Everything's okay. Dad's there too.
Yeah.
You know this. Just jump up here and hold on tight. 400 grams. Let's sit down for a moment. Dad's there too.
So,
look. Perfect.
Over at the Zebras, two mares are still quarrelling over a baby. Tony has taken the three animals out of the group.
We've decided to mark the mother with a blue spray so that everyone knows which the real mother is. That's especially important for our colleagues who bring the animals in at night.
Tony wants to make sure that the foal shares the box in the evening with his biological mother. Although the stripe pattern of all zebras is as unique as a human fingerprint, there is still danger of confusion. And besides, he only allows Vicky and her youngster back into the open enclosure. The jealous mare stays in the stable for a while. The little one needs some rest and to be able to drink in peace.
When she's also outside, she keeps stealing the foal from Vicky. She's the significantly stronger alpha animal. Mother and foal would never be together and the foal couldn't suckle. That would be too much stress. That's why she's going to stay in the stable until lunchtime.
An important break for Mum Vicky and her offspring. Lead mare Yassi can return to the group in a few hours. It's been 1.5 hours since his birth, and the alpaca fawn still hasn't found his mother's udders. The milk is important for him to muster his strength. Keeper Volker shows the vets the new addition to the zoo.
Hello, sweetie. Has he had anything to drink yet?
Volker is only satisfied when he sees himself that the little one drinks. But the veterinary examination of young animals is purely routine.
In the case of ungulates, we carry out the examination on the first day. We take a look at the navel, whether it's a boy or a girl, and what impression the young animal makes. Then he gets his chip, and that's that.
With the help of a syringe, the doctor places the tiny electrochip under the skin. This makes the animal instantly recognizable at all times. Because of the vet's years of experience, the alpaca baby only feels a short jab.
The navel looks good, boy or girl. And it's another boy. Okay. He has to straighten up his ears a little bit, but otherwise he looks good. Oh yes, the syringe. You've got it, huh? It's vitamin E and selenium. Camels often have a shortage. This jab is to ensure that he doesn't have any of these deficiencies. We can't administer it via his food, as he only drinks milk. So, off to Mummy. Have a nice day. Drink something. Have you seen him drink anything today?
No, he keeps looking.
On their first day of life, a newborn alpaca needs a tenth of his body weight in mother's milk. In the end, even Mona's little lad eventually found the teats. The garden boa is a tropical constrictor and viviparous. Christine has discovered a boa baby and wants to show it to her boss, Guido. In one fell swoop, the boa gives birth to 40 young.
You can only spot one baby, but she's bound to have more. So we've got to find them and see how many and whether they're healthy. Let's see what colors they are.
And here's the first one.
Typical garden boa. Goes straight to threat mode. Ready to strike. They'd love to take a bite out of you.
She's unbelievably long.
Yes, very. They're already 35 to 40 centimeters at birth.
When fully grown, they can reach lengths of more than 2 meters.
This was the umbilical cord. The navel's healed well, the cord's gone. Couldn't be better.
Garden boas are aggressive, but not poisonous.
Take out the hollow branch.
It could be that perhaps a baby snake has hidden itself in the cork bark.
Wow!
Oh my!
Oh my God!
Garden boas come from the rainforests of Central and South America.
It's a real tangle of snake babies.
Oh wow, the colors! That orange is really cool.
They have different colors and markings.
That's number four. Here comes five.
This one's fine too. They're all in the best of health. But first, they just have tiny teeth. That hardly hurts at all. Let's have a look at this bunch of rascals. It's unbelievable the way they're looking at us.
Fantastic.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. For a first litter, that's excellent. I'm really pleased. It's fantastic. And great fun.
Brilliant. Come here, little babies.
In just a few weeks, the young snakes will peel off their skin for the first time, as snakeskin doesn't grow with the animal. Motherless lemur baby Mangoki is still being reared by Heidi and his father, Gerard, who obviously can't supply him with milk. The poor little thing is hardly gaining any weight.
You have to drink a little bit more. One more sip. He doesn't want to.
Mangoki is a ring-tailed lemur from Madagascar, where they solely occur. Their ringed tail is characteristic of them. When fully grown, they can weigh anywhere between 2 and 3.5 kilograms. But Mangoki has a long way to go.
There you are. He loves these pellets. And he learned to fight from the start. If there's something tasty going around, he'll hide it from the others. He'll hold his tail in front of his face and sit there eating, without the others seeing what he has. He had to do this at an early age, otherwise he wouldn't have survived. Sometimes he stuffs everything into his mouth in one go, whatever works.
Lemurs subsist mainly on fruit, but they also eat leaves, blossoms, buds and small animals, such as insects.
You've got it crossways.
The pellets consist of dried maize, cereals and fruit.
If you look after him every day, of course you bond. He remembers exactly who feeds him. Look, do you want some?
It's important for his digestion, growth and well-being that he drinks adequately.
If he doesn't want to drink, I'll give him some fruit and try again an hour later. He has to be fed 4 to 5 times a day. That's why we feed him before breakfast, before lunch, after lunch, and in the evening. Bless you.
Thuringian forest donkeys have light brown-grey coloured fur. But not young donkey Emil. He is dark. There are only 20 animals left belonging to this old species of domestic donkey. Emil has been scratching himself an awful lot these past 2 days. Keeper Thomas has therefore called the vet.
Now what's wrong with the little guy?
He's got bald ears. A fungal infection, perhaps?
Well, let's take a closer look, shall we?
Not until Emil is 5 to 7 years old is he fully grown and resilient. In the Middle Ages, donkeys were used to carry heavy loads. Apart from bald ears, the 3-month-old foal is a mischievous little so-and-so.
He's fooling around again. Stay where you are. Hey, come here.
Unlike horses, which are flight animals, donkeys mostly stand as stiff as a poker when they feel threatened.
Yeah, the hair's gone, but the skin is relatively intact. Here are a few light changes. Perhaps one of the others had a chew of him. I need a few samples. Please get me a few hairs and a piece of skin. Then soon we will be able to see if it's a fungus or not. And if it is, we can give him the right treatment.
Donkeys are prone to fungus and parasite infection. A humid climate or a weakened immune system can cause them skin problems.
Now comes the not quite so nice part. You have to scratch until tiny blood droplets appear on the surface.
Emil endures it all bravely.
He did it well.
All done?
Yeah, it's all okay. That's enough. It takes a few days, but then we'll know what's up.
At worst, Emil will have to go through several washes with an antifungus medium. After the unpleasant treatment, he seeks a little consolation from his mum. All 3 Gentoo penguin eggs from the breeding season have hatched. More babies. Sebastian takes care of the seabirds from the southern hemisphere that build their nests out of stone.
Now I want to feed our penguin colony. We also have a very small young animal, a little latecomer. I'd like to check whether he's fit and healthy.
In the nest of stones, the father is warming the chick. The parents go hunting in turns. One parent always remains with the offspring in the first few weeks. Each grown-up gentoo penguin eats 600 to 700 grams of fish per day. Just like in the open sea, they have to dive for their fish, albeit with minor exceptions.
I only feed the ones by hand that are sitting on the nest and have young. We feed them twice a day, but in the water. But if a parent spends the whole day on the nest, they don't get anything. This is why I always serve the fish in the afternoon close to the nest, so that everyone gets some.
The chicks get their food directly out of the beaks of their parents.
The little one is 4 days old. If you look, you can still see his grey, fluffy and downy feathers. When they get a little bigger, they lose their feathers, bit by bit. He's a good example, the one over there. The first to fall out are the downy ones on their heads, after which they get their proper feathers.
The feathers are watertight. Air is also stored in the dense plumage. In addition to layers of fat tissue, this ensures good warmth isolation. The little latecomer now has to take care of those layers of fat herself by eating. In their first weeks, oriental small-clawed otters remain in the burrow. Before they can join their parents in the big enclosure, they have to be examined and treated by the vet. Like dogs, otters can also contract the infectious disease distemper.
We're vaccinating the babies for the first time today. At 6 weeks, it's a good time to do it. The repeat date will be in 4 weeks' time. It will protect them for a year.
You ready?
To assess the baby's general condition, Adriana and Klaus weigh the tots regularly.
Hello. Are you the fat one or the thin one?
If they don't gain weight, they could be ill.
Last time they weighed 316 and 342. Please, 400? 378.
Small-clawed otters are indigenous to Southeast Asia. They are the smallest otters of them all. They can be 50 centimeters long, around 80, taking in the tail. Here, in addition to the inoculation, the babies receive their ID chip, which is placed under the skin via a cannula.
He looks good. He doesn't fight back like some of the others. He's just 6 weeks old, and I think he's in a good mood. He's gaining weight, that's the main thing.
Then let's hope that the other one's a bit heavier. Oh yes, he feels a lot fatter. Although, he's pretty much the same. I'd say 385? 358. Oh well, they've both put on weight.
Small-clawed otters are very friendly. They live together in families and like to play with each other.
That's really sweet, especially when the little ones are in the enclosure and you see all the family together. They trot along after the adults or get carried. It's so sweet. Okay, you two, I have to clean up a bit now so that you can have a fresh bed.
They'll manage all right. I'll see them again in 4 weeks for the repeat jab, and then they can soon go into the outer enclosure.
Gentoo penguins feed their chicks daily with huge portions. They grow accordingly fast. After 3 months, they're almost the same size as their parents.
The parents eat fish, and they produce a kind of liquidy, fishy porridge out of it. Then they regurgitate this into the little one's beaks, and the larger the chick, the bigger the pieces of fish.
Once they are around 4 months, they can catch the fish, like the big ones.
Okay, buddy, you've had enough. So let's put the rest back into the water.
Gentoo penguins are considered to be the fastest of all penguins. They can easily reach speeds of 30 kilometers per hour. And they can dive to about 100 meters.
Okay, all gone, all gone.
Unlike horse hooves, donkey hooves are adjusted to dry ground. Their ancestors originated in northern African desert regions. But like horses, the hooves are extremely important for the animal's health, and they must be looked after accordingly. Keeper Thomas wants to get Emile, the donkey foal, used to it.
You have to cut donkey hooves, sometimes even shoe them. I prefer to start at an early age so they get used to it. That makes it easier for both of us if their feet need treatment for any reason. The training's very short at the beginning. He doesn't want to be bothered longer than that. In time, we can increase it. Tomorrow, I'll show him the hoof pick and play around with it a bit. That way he'll realize that it's nothing nasty. He has to understand that it's something positive.
A donkey mare enjoys a very tight bond with her child. This remains until the birth of her next foal. The little ones play a lot with their mothers if they can't find any mates of a similar age. When playing, they practice the behavior of adult stallions, including fighting.
He looks sweet, but you have to watch out. This also has to do with dominance. You have to show him his limits while he's still young. He looks sweet chewing away, but in no time at all, they can get cheeky. If he carries on like that when he's adult, that won't be much fun. In general, donkeys have good characters. If you treat them fairly, they'll be fair to you. It is true that they're stubborn, they have their own minds, but who doesn't? You can see their great character by looking at the little one here. He's so eager to learn, and that makes it fun. Working with animals like these is really enjoyable.
After his first well-behaved training session, Emile wants something from Thomas that he understands only too well: strokes and cuddles.